Hi, so I am fully aware actually it does need cutting at the moment, my hair. I've put off cutting it this week till next week, so next week brings me nearer to Christmas so that I don't have to have it cut over the Christmas period, because that's not going to be quite so easy to do. The reason I've put the title of this vlog as it is because of the questions I get over my hair. Because I work in retail, I get an awful lot of questions all day long, every day. People are always asking or mentioning or saying something about the hair. Now, the one thing I didn't do was I didn't do this for attention. So I've actually got quite poor or very poor confidence. I have no confidence and I have no self-esteem, or I have very low self-esteem, which is something that came out of the counselling earlier, like last year. But one of the things I did do was, my colleague that I work with has bright pink hair, and she's had that pink hair for quite a long time. She did it mainly because she had radiotherapy a few years before. She was very ill. When her hair grew back, it never grew back a nice colour. It's all sort of like spaghetti coloured, very yellowy white. She didn't like it, so she did her hair very, very bright. So we had a case where lots and lots of people asked all the time, why does nobody else do it? Why is it only one person in the shop doing it? She doesn't really talk about it very often, so she just said, I do it because I do it. But it felt she was the odd one out. So I did it once. I thought I'll give it a go. So it was Halloween 2017. I'd been on my own for the first time in my life since I was 18. I've never been alone. I haven't been with somebody. So from 2017, obviously May 17 onwards, I've been single without a partner or anyone like that. So I thought, you know what? Just to support Tracy and just to see how it goes, give me maybe a bit of a boost, not a confidence boost, but maybe see if I can do something without being too worried or too scared of it. I did it for Halloween. It didn't come out as well. It was a very sort of darkish green colour, but work didn't mind. They couldn't really mind because of my colleague with hers bright pink or bright red or whatever colour she was. And I sort of stuck with it and I've got used to it now. It's something I'm very used to. But it doesn't mean I didn't get a lot of stick for it. My ex-wife absolutely hates it. And when I first did it, she was like, oh my God, what the hell have you done? She was very much against it. So it was a case of, if I had to go to a parents' meeting or something like that, which, to be honest with you, I think I've probably only done once in the last year. I think I haven't, well, not even that. I don't even think I've been to the school in the last year, probably before that, actually. If I was going to go to anything like that, she was very much like, oh, you can't go like that. You're going to have to wear a hat. Which was, no, that's not going to happen, is it? So it was like, no, I'm not doing that at all. I don't want the kids being looked at funny by their teachers. The kids are going to draw a picture of their dad at some point. I don't want them drawing a picture of their dad with green hair. And then the teacher's going, what the hell are you doing? Your dads don't have green hair. So when I did go to one, you could see my green hair. I did consider very, very briefly for a very short time. I've got the perfect hat to cover it up with so it won't cause any distress. I'm sure that would have been suitable, wouldn't it? Not. No, I'm not being bullied into changing it or not having it because of anyone else's views. It is what it is. As I say, my self-confidence, I haven't no self-confidence as such. So I don't have a social circle. So I don't go out anywhere. I don't do anything. I'm in here 99% of the time. Occasionally I'll go out and take some pictures. But if I go out anywhere, it's always on my own terms with myself. I don't have anyone to go with. So I don't have, I said, I don't do social interaction, that sort of stuff. So I'm not really with people that are going to talk about it anyway. It's just people out there see it and go, ooh, it's got green hair. Of course, having said that, I do get asked an awful lot of questions about it. I said this, I work in retail, so I get asked a lot of questions during the day, and every single day always get questions. Usually it's along the lines of things like, oh, are you Irish? No. Did you lose the bet? Nope. Was it for a bet? No. Is it for charity? No, but in a way it's sort of supportive of somebody who is very ill. So in a sense, it's sort of. And also to help with my mental illness. You do get a few jokes. Obviously, you get people like, oh, there's grass growing on your hair, or did you know your hair is green, or have you eaten a lot of Brussels sprouts, or are you the Joker, or the Incredible Hulk, or
the
Grinch?
none of which I am.
What do you want?
For the drone, for the spark. I've got a green Joker on that. I've got a Joker sticker on my locker. I have a few Joker bits and bobs. Cuddles has his Joker outfit, so I don't mind that. Not the recent Joker. I'm more thinking like the Jack Nicholson type Joker from the first Batman film.
Never rub another man's rhubarb.
But I do like purple as well. Purple's another one of my favourite colours. So green is my favourite colour. Purple's my second favourite colour. So it does sort of match in, although it's not anything to do related with the Joker at all. It was sort of, I've always liked green since I was very, very small. And I've always liked purple since I was a bit older.
As my plastic surgeon always said, if you gotta go, go with a smile.
In the time since I've done it, so as I said, I've done it in October 2017. So since then, I've had it said every day you get comments, but I've never really had much in the way of abuse as such. I think I've probably only had a couple of occasions. I think once was the first time I went to Brighton, and I was in the McDonald's, I think it was. It was late night. It was late night. And some lads walked past and said, ooh, ducky, sort of thing. Obviously quite homophobic. Now, I'm not gay, but I'm not homophobic either. It's very rude of somebody to even think mentioning that to somebody. And the colour of your hair doesn't choose your sexuality or doesn't show or have anything to do with your sexuality. They thought because of the hair colour, and then they were rude. So even if I was gay, it would have been very rude to even mention anything. And the only other time was when I was doing the video which had the motel in it up the M2, which I posted on one of the vlogs here. Somebody drove past in a car as I was walking back to do some more footage, and somebody shouted something out of the window. I can't remember what it was. But 99% of the time, it's always good comments. Usually most guys or blokes will normally just say, oh, nice hair, mate. That sort of thing. You don't get a lot of comments when you're out, but when you do, nobody's ever really rude. They're just normally like, oh, wicked hair, mate. And again, if a couple of vlogs, maybe you might have heard it a couple of times when people have said about it. I didn't do it for attention. I didn't do it because people wanted people to look at me. I've got used to it now. It does come in handy for some of the things like the car shows. When I'm doing photography now, and my Instagram profile, so my Instagram profile is Nom Nom Green Hair, so underscore between. And when I'm doing car shows, it's a lot easier for me now. People walk around the car shows and they say, oh, well, how do I get my picture taken to one of the event providers or the event owners? They'll just say to them, oh, well, go and hunt out the guy with the green hair. He's got the camera. He'll take your pictures for you. So that's quite helpful in that respect, and it gets me noticed in that respect. So that's why it tends to stay as it is. So that's what guys tend to feel about it. It's a bit different with women. Now you get some women that will ask you how you've done it and what you've done with your hair. And then you see a pretty girl out somewhere in a shop, you're shopping or something like that. Now when I mean pretty, I've already met and I only know one beautiful woman. The most beautiful woman in the world, the most beautiful woman I've ever seen, and most beautiful woman I've ever been able to go out with. So there isn't anyone else who matches up to her in beauty and stuff like that. So isn't, to me, at the moment still, there isn't another woman in the world. She is the only truly beautiful woman in the world. However, you do see attractive women out and about. Now, they're more attractive to somebody else that would be interested in somebody else that would probably go after them. I'm just a case, well, they're pretty, and that don't pay any attention. But that doesn't help when they say something about your hair. So you're out shopping, you see her go and think, well, she's pretty. You carry on walking around the shop, walk past them and they say, oh, I really like your hair, mate. And this is where my self-confidence comes in. I'm like, thank you. And I run off like a little child. I feel obliged to say something back. I always feel a bit like, oh, I should say something back. Ah, nice hair. But, you know, other than just say thank you and running away, I should say, oh, thank you very much. Nice dress, nice legs, I don't know, whatever, something nice, thanks. I don't really know what to say. So compliments in that respect, I'm really not very good with at all.
Nice to see you too.
Whereas I suppose, you know, if you're a confident person, and I said, I mean, I'm not interested, so there's only one woman for me, but if I was interested, I probably still wouldn't know what to do, would I? Are there any downsides to the green hair? The problem I had with the Colour Crazy hair colour, which is stuff I used a lot, because they do some very bright colours, Lime Twist, Toxic UV Green. It's a great colour, but it doesn't last as long, and it comes off and colours everything green. So it's not that good. So, and that's always done that. And it's only a customer told me a few months ago, that, I mean, I tried Manic Panic before, but they said, no, you should stick to Manic Panic, because Manic Panic Electric Lizard, or any of the Manic Panic colours, don't tend to fade. So they don't fade anywhere near as good, which is true. This has lasted a hell of a lot longer than the Colour Crazy would. And they don't tend to run. So I haven't had any issues with that recently. It's been fine. The pillow's still the same colour as it always is. It hasn't gone green. The only downside over time that I really had was initially with using the other Colour Crazy. When I wear my headphones when I'm trying to get to sleep, I manage to somehow darken. I mean, the headphones are bright lime green anyway, but somehow it's managed to darken them. Maybe where I've been laying in against the pillow, and somehow it's stained them. I can't get the stains off. But to be honest with you, they're bright green anyway. I mean, I'm not going to be, you know, who's going to say, oh, look at this, take your headphones. Who cares? They've got a bit extra green on them. I still like it. I don't want to change it just yet because, as I said, I've got used to it now. I don't really want it black and grey, but you know, if I had to go back to black, I wouldn't stop me going back to black. I don't think I'd ever put products in it anymore. I think I've given up on the idea of having gel and stuff in it. I cut it short enough so it doesn't need it anymore.
Yep. I said it before and I'll say it again. Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
Okay, other than talking about the hair, what else has been going on? Well, recently, since I did my last video, the laws changed around drones and drone flying. If your drone weighs over 249 grams, you have to have a CAA registration, which is a simple thing. You've got to go online. You've got to pay £9 to register yourself as an operator. It's free if you register yourself as a pilot and you fly the drones, but you don't own any. But if you own any drones, you've got to register yourself as an operator, which costs you £9. You have to do a questionnaire, which is 20 questions. If you've been flying a drone and you have experience of drones, then you'll know the answers to these questions pretty straightforward. It's a 16 question pass mark, so if you get less than 16, you don't pass. Any more than 16, you pass. Luckily, I got 20. It's sort of standard stuff you should realistically have paid attention to and you should know anyway. What you must do, you must have a sticker now on the side of your drones with a registration number. So you must have a registration number on the drone. It doesn't have to be fully visible. It has to be easily accessible. The only reason you need it is if you get asked by an official, and only an official, nobody else really matters. So a police person or somebody like that says to you, have you got your drone registration? You have to have your drone license with you. Now, at the moment, waiting for the paperwork to come through the post, so I've got it on my phone as an email. It's good enough, and having the registration on the side of the drone is good enough. So you show them that, you show them your license. You don't have your drone license and you don't have your registration on your drone, you can get an on-the-spot fine of up to £1,000, which is not good. Whilst I was doing my drone registration, at the same time as doing my own drone registration, I thought it might be an idea. I've been using my Huawei phone for drone use. That's my normal phone and also my drone controller. Which I thought was a bit daft. So for ages I've been looking to buy a very, very, very cheap second phone or second hand phone that I can use just for flying a drone. And luckily I came upon a slightly battered, it's got a bit of a dent in the back, Sony Xperia phone. To be perfectly honest, I don't even know what model it is, but it's Sony Xperia. It's got roughly the same size case as the Huawei, slightly smaller screen, not by a lot, but it's a little bit smaller screen, but nothing's on this other than drone software. So all I've got is a DJI Go software. That's the only thing I'm ever going to put on it. I can then have the phone in the pocket. So if somebody does come along and ask me now, if I'm actually up in the air flying a drone and a policeman comes along and says to me, have you got your drone license on you? So, well, the drone's up in the air, but the license is on this one if you want to see it. This is purely for flying the drones. So if I get any connection issues, which I sometimes get with Huawei sometimes on the Spark especially will come up with disconnected. This one, both use the same connector. Nice thing about this, reason I've got it, is it's got a USB-C connector, same as the Huawei. So it's all the leads and everything work, because as we go back to where I mentioned the hair, obviously I've got green leads as well as a green drone and lots of other green bits and bobs in the car. Green here, green there, green everywhere, green here. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching the video. If you've got any questions, then leave comments down below. I will answer your questions, whether it's questions about the hair, comments, mental illness, that sort of stuff, self-confidence, anything like that. If it's about the drones, the drone licensing, the use of a phone and phone software with a drone, anything you can think of, if you want to just type it down below, I will get back to you and I will let you know what's going on. In the next vlog, I may have a competition to win a watch, because I've got a watch that I'm looking to do a review of. When I do the review, I may well give it away, but I'll work out the logistics of how we're going to get to a point where it can be won. So anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.